Hi, my name is Martha Zameda. I'm an applications engineer at Keysight Technologies. In this video, I'll discuss dynamic spectrum sharing, also known as LTE 5G coexistence, from the physical layer perspective. Today, we'll review what dynamic spectrum sharing is and the motivation behind it, look at the techniques adapted by 5GNR in order to coexist with LTE, and finally, we'll see a demo of verifying a DSS implementation without impacting the LTE performance. I'll be using Keysight's PathWave Signal Generation and Analysis software to illustrate the concept and show a demo. Trial licenses are available so you can explore what I'm covering in more detail. Let's first understand what DSS is. DSS allows coexistence between LTE and NR in the same carrier using spectrum sharing. The image shows an example of an LTE deployment with two component carriers. Option one is static spectrum sharing, where one of the LTE carriers is replaced by 5GNR. The drawback with this approach is initially the main traffic will continue to be through LTE, so this approach will make it difficult to handle the traffic demand. The second option, which is the most attractive, is dynamic spectrum sharing, where LTE continues to use both carriers, but one carrier can also be used by 5GNR. Resources will be dynamically assigned based on the traffic condition. The motivation for DSS is wide area coverage. Current NR frequencies are in mid and high bands, which are important for capacity. For wide area coverage, lower operating bands must be used, and those bands are currently occupied by LTE. DSS will allow 5GNR deployments in lower frequencies for wide area coverage. Let's now look at the techniques adopted by 5GNR. LTE and NR systems need to be synchronized in both time and frequency domain. When using 15 kHz subcarrier spacing for NR, both technologies can operate on a common time frequency grid. NR can also operate in a 30 kHz spacing. However, 15 kHz is expected to be used for initial implementation. For the rest of the video, 15 kHz spacing is assumed. One important point about DSS is the fact that it is transparent to LTE devices. This means NR must operate around LTE's always-on signals, such as the cell-specific reference signal. For 5G data channel, the PDSCH, it is time and frequency multiplexed or rate matched around the LTE cell-specific reference signals, which are the green allocations shown here. The PDSCH DMRS, however, can get impacted by DSS. When there is an additional DMRS symbol, it occupies symbol number 11, but there is an LTE CRS on that symbol. In this case, 3GPP has defined an alternative DMRS position to move the location to symbol number 12. On the other hand, the SSPBCH beams cannot be rate matched since it occupies four OFDM symbols. Because of the LTE CRS, there is a maximum of three empty symbols within an LTE slot or a maximum of two when using four antenna ports. Therefore, other options are required. Option one is to use an LTE MBSFN subframe. This method restricts the CRS and control signaling to the first two symbols. The remaining empty symbols can fit one or two SSPBCH beams within the subframe. Option two is to use 30 kHz subcarrier spacing. This results in a mixed numerology, and it has its own challenges that's beyond the topic of this video. Now, let's move to a demo to highlight what we talked about. The end goal is to verify the DSS implementation does not impact the LTE performance. We will use 10 MHz LTE signal with 64 QAM modulation. The always-on LTE channels and signals are shown throughout the allocation here. The 64 QAM data in red occupies all subframes except for subframes 1, 2, and 3, which are occupied by NR. Subframe 1 is an MBSFN subframe where you see empty symbols without CRS to be occupied by the NR SSPBCH beams. Let's now look at the NR configuration. Here, we see NR occupying slots 1, 2, and 3. By enabling the LTE coexistence, the LTE CRS, which are the white bars, are displayed. two beams of the SSPVCH and the PDSCH are transmitted in the MBSF and subframe. On the other two slots, PDSCH is red matched around LTE CRS. And there is an additional PDSCH DMRS transmitted. The combined waveform is downloaded into a signal generator. Let's now demodulate the signal using the 89600 VSA software. Given the LTE and NR systems need to be synchronized, I am acquiring the data in synchronous mode and demodulating NR and LTE simultaneously. I have enabled DSS under 5G NR. The left half of the demodulated results are for 5G and the right half for LTE. The bottom traces show the frame allocations. Overlaying these two traces show both technologies occupying the full radio frame. On the LTE constellation diagram, we see an error causing high EVM. The color and marker indicate it is caused by the CRS. You can also see that in the EVM versus symbol trace, coupling markers between the LTE and NR traces show the high LTE EVM corresponds to symbol number 11 of the NR PDSCH, which transmits the additional DMRS. Let's go back to the signal creation. So you can see LTE CRS on symbol number 11 colliding with the PDSCH DMRS also on symbol number 11. Let's turn on the alternate position for the DMRS so we can move it to symbol number 12. Let's go ahead and demodulate this waveform. On the analysis side, we now see a clean constellation diagram for LTE with 0.2% EVM. For 5G NR, let's enable the alternate DMRS position. Now, you can see very clean EVM of about 0.16%. The NR 3D power trace shows the combination of 5G NR channels and the LTE CRS. NR occupying three slots, the LTE CRS in cyan color across the full frame. We can measure the CRS power and it's about minus 38 dBm. Finally, looking at the decoding results, we'll confirm a 5G UE will be able to decode the 5G transmission from the combined signal. We now see the CRC pass for all the 5G channels. In conclusion, you have seen an overview of DSS, as well as the importance of verifying a DSS implementation to make sure it doesn't impact the LTE performance. To learn more, download the PathWave signal creation and analysis software with a trial license using the links provided here. Thank you for watching.